Faf du Plessis picks his two favorites going into the T20 World Cup later this year. Who are those two teams? I will tell you. Uske baad dekhenge. What has Joe Root said about Robinson's controversial tweets? And in the end, the date for the IPL 14th season is out. When is the final going to be held? When is the 14th season going to resume? All those details only in today's episode of News Tracker. Hello everybody. I hope you're doing well and keeping safe. My name is Nivedna Prabhu. This is the show where we keep you updated about everything happening in the world of cricket. So if you want to stay updated, do not forget to subscribe to Cricket Tracker if you haven't done so already. And without wasting time, let's get into this video to find out what's making news in the world of cricket. Now, the countdown and excitement for the ICC T20 World Cup, of course, which is scheduled later this year, has begun. Many experts, cricketers, all are giving their choices as to, of course, who do they think they're going to win, who are their favourite players, and of course, who are their favourite teams as well. And the latest to join that bandwagon of giving their expert opinions is Faf du Plessis. Now, he's gone on to say that two teams are his favourite going into this competition. Who is that? Well, on one hand, he thinks it's India, and on the other hand, he thinks it's West Indies. But if you're wondering what he really is looking forward to in the West Indian team to be one of the favourites going to this competition, I will tell you, because Faf has given his statement about it. Now, Faf said, "The shorter the format, you feel like there are more teams that can have a chance. If I look at the teams with good firepower and experience, you have to look at West Indies and the fact that they have brought back all their players, almost given them a directive to try and be the team that wins three times." Now, that's a fantastic way to look at it, but you let me know, do you agree with Faf, and are these two teams the ones to win or probably the favourites to win? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. Sportspersons, of course, are public figures, and it becomes a lot more important when they're putting out their thoughts there in the public, and especially on social media, of course. Now, if you've seen in the past couple of days, those tweets, controversial tweets of Ollie Robinson has been making the rounds, and of course, he's had the repercussion of it as well. But on the other hand, in terms of what does Joe Root, the England test skipper, think about the entire incident? Well, for starters, he was not mincing his words while talking about these controversial tweets. For number one, he said it's not acceptable, especially in terms of the standards of cricket in the country. And now Joe Root has spoken more about it. What has he said? Well, I will tell you. Now, Joe said he's contributed well with the bat. His performance with the ball was excellent. But in regards to the stuff that happened off the field, it's not acceptable within our game. We all know that. He addressed the dressing room straight away. He showed a lot of remorse from the point afterwards. Now, this entire thing started back in 2012 and 13 when Robinson had dropped tweets slamming the Muslim community and the people of the Asian ethnicity. Now, Robinson, of course, issued an apology. However, the England and Wales Cricket Board suspended him from all forms of international cricket, which, of course, like I said right in the beginning, that was the repercussion that he had to face for those controversial tweets. Now, this, of course, is Joe Root's stance on the entire episode and you know, how it has really changed the way how everybody is, of course, looking also at Robinson in terms of these controversial tweets. But we'll just have to wait and watch, you know, for how long you know, this ban is going to be on Robinson, and we'll have to wait it out to see when he will back to be playing for his country. Well, moving on to some better news, we all were waiting for this date. You know, of course, everybody is looking forward to resuming of the 14th season of the IPL. For starters, of course, the venue has changed to the UAE, which all of us are aware of. But the latest news coming in is that the dates are finally in, and in terms of the fact that when is the final going to be held as well. But before I give you the dates, of course, in terms of the BCCI, I was very keen to have that 25-day window to ensure that, you know, everything goes smoothly. So for starters, it is going to be resuming on September 19, but the final is going to be taking place on October 15. That's right, everybody is going to be looking forward to that date. But a BCCI source has, you know, spoken about this entire development and how it really took place, because it's of course going to be affecting several other factors. You know, most importantly, many other you know, cricketing nations are going to be having tight national you know, kind of events happening during that particular time. So the BCCI official has given a particular statement about how those things were also kept into mind. Now, what did the official say? Well, I will tell you. The official said the discussions went really well, and with the ECB already giving us the oral nod to host the event ahead of the BCCI SJM, it was about closing the deal over the last week. So, you know, that is it. You know, they have got that particular nod that they required, and they had that special general meeting that happened, you know, on May 29th. But after that, of course, the decision of UAE came. But most importantly, now the final date has been set. And if everything goes smoothly, which is the most important thing during a pandemic because everything is so unpredictable, at least a date is out, and probably the BCCI is also looking to have all those arrangements in terms of not only in UAE but also with Emirates Cricket Board to ensure that whether they're looking at all these teams coming in. And also the other aspect would be the fact that what is going to happen to overseas players, which is probably the next question in everybody's mind. But before we get to that point, I want to know from you, how excited are you now that the dates are in? Are you going to be super excited during that period? What do you think is going to happen now it's going to be resuming, that news is finally here? So let me know all your predictions in the comment section below. Well, but that is a wrap on this video. If you like the video, give it a big thumbs up and follow all our social media channels, including our Telegram channel, which has some amazing fantasy tips for you and also some match winning combinations, so you wouldn't want to miss it, trust me. My name is Nivedna Prabhu. I'll be seeing you very soon. Until I see you next time, if you haven't subscribed to Cricket Tracker as yet, do that quickly so that next time I'm back, you are going to meet me and we're going to discuss everything happening in the world of cricket. I will see you very soon. Until then, take care and stay safe. Bye-bye.